Okay, all right. I know I haven't done the science for a while, but I have to discuss frequency pushing. Now, when we are in the discussion of Mars, we're talking about Mars. You know, we have water there on Mars, and there's very much the possibility of the someday of habitating it with a colony, and that colony will need water, if there's not enough there already on supply. So. I'm devising a way to get the water there. Okay, so to get the water there from planet Earth, how are we going to ship it? We have to ship the water from Earth to Mars. Okay, so to ship the water easily, without rockets, okay, we're talking frequency, a frequency push, a frequency travel. Okay, so when I'm talking frequency, we already know we have the frequency of the planet Earth, we have the frequency of the planet Mars. Okay, so they have their sound frequency, you know, that vibration. All right. But we also, you know, easily enough is with you know the microphone, you know that frequency, you know, how loud, how not loud, amplified. Okay, so if you look at it this way, okay, let's say you have the frequency, I'll go with 80. Okay, let's say right here is at 80, all right. And so you set this little, this water, it'll be a water capsule ship. You set that water capsule ship at 80. So it is giving off that same frequency. So in a sense, it will just stay and hover near Earth. Let's say Earth is 80. The little capsule is at 80, so it will stay at 80, close by. All right, it won't leave. All right, it'll remain in the orbit. We want it to leave. We want it to go to Mars. Okay, so to get it to Mars, let's say Mars is at 90. Okay, so to get it to Mars, we have to have it release. We have to think of a dandelion. Think of a dandelion and one of those pods in the wind, how it just releases. Okay, we want it to actually not feel that it has magnetized here. It can't be a heavy. I'm at the theory that it cannot be a heavy. You cannot amplify it up. You cannot make it a 90. It will just stay here. More like a big foot. You understand, a foot on the planet, rather than having freedom. Freedom to fly would give it would be at 70. Okay, so we set the amplitude of this little water capsule ship at 70, and so then it heads out, and we somehow have a directional on it. Okay, so we set a directional to the planet Mars. All right, so you set this little water capsule ship out there, and you say go. So now it's chugging along, and it gets there to 70, and then it's at the ratio of 70, and then it's found Mars. Now Mars is, gosh dang it, where is it? Mars is over here. Mars is at 90. So it's a heavy. Mars is a heavy 90. So because it's a heavy 90, it's not going to accept this lightweight 70, you know, going in. It's just not going to accept it. If anything, it's going to push it away. We don't want that frequency ship pushed away. We want it to land on Mars. So to get it to land on Mars, it has to have the same stereotypical frequency. It just has to just be like, yeah, basta. And so yeah, basta would be at 90. So what has to happen is somewhere midway along the travel, After it's gone 70 and it's left Earth, somewhere midway along the travel, it has to increase in amplification. It has to go 70 to 80. And then it has to go from 80 to 90. And then it will just be like a homing pigeon, one of those homing pigeons, you know, and it'll just be a homing pigeon right in to Mars. All right, so that's my frequency. I discussed that a little bit, or I wrote it down a little bit on my energy my energy papers that I have out there. But yeah, it's about frequency, spaceship travel, and that's my theory. That's my theory of how it's done. So at some point we have to have the amplification, you know that levy, know that levy moment where it has to drop or it has to increase, okay? And so likewise on return, it's the same. Now, I'm not saying it's a fast travel, but maybe on this particular reasoning, you know, it's just a water supply unit. As a water supply unit, yeah, you know, maybe you just don't need it that speedy. So, yeah. Anyhoot, yeah, I had to set that one out.